What do you think this Giro means for you, for what you can aim target at the in the future? I mean, you came here a bit in the unknown, I suppose. Now you have shown what you're capable of.
I mean, for sure, it will be hard to repeat a Giro like this, but luckily I left myself room by not winning anything, so there's always room for improvement. But no, I'm really looking forward to seeing how I come out of this as a rider and you know how that changes what kind of rider I'll be in the future, what I'll target, and we'll see. Got to recover from it first.
Derek, firstly, congratulations, mate. An unbelievable Giro. They're joking today that you can actually get caught for that one award you look like winning. I don't think it's going to happen. But it'll probably be a bigger story if you run second anyway after 4 seconds. But just let's go back to that last mountain stage where you got second. We spoke to you that morning and you were saying, oh, look, I think I'm out of energy, the legs are gone. But you put up one of the most amazing rides.
There's something special about being out there. I mean, right from the start, I thought I didn't have the legs, but yeah, it's the Giro d'Italia, and you're out there, and there's the fans, and it gives you a little extra something. So, for sure, it wasn't a stage maybe for someone who's 75 kilos to win, but, you know, you can always dream, and I went out there and gave it everything I had, and, yeah, the fans were a massive help, so they gave me... They brought my legs back a little bit.
Well, I suppose when you saw Michael Hepburn up the front, then he said, well, if he can do it, I can do it.
Oh, he was flying. No, it was unbelievable. It was, no, but he's a really good guy, and it was cool to be in a break with riders like that, for sure.